Imagine an Earth-like planet far larger than our own. NASA has actually discovered numerous exoplanets, dubbed super-Earths, which are over twice the size of our tiny homeworld. Most of these super-Earths can't support life, but it's interesting to imagine what sorts of life forms we'd discover on a super-sized version of a habitable world. Phtanum B is a speculative project created by the brilliant SteveMobCannon, who imagines just such a planet, and the incredible alien life that might evolve on it. And as usual, I have links where you can follow and support his work down below. So, for this entry into the archive, we'll be voyaging to the extraordinary alien world of Phtanum B. The planet gets its name from the Greek word phtan, which translates as to arrive first, a reference to the idea that Phtanum B is the first planet with alien life that humanity has arrived on in this fictional narrative. At almost twice the size of Earth, with a higher surface gravity and thicker atmosphere, conditions on Phtanum B are quite different from on our own planet. And yet the life here is downright awe-inspiring, reaching colossal sizes despite the higher gravity. But we'll come back to that later in the video. For now, let's discuss how humanity first reached these alien shores. I wish I could tell you that in this timeline, humans grew into a grand, interstellar civilization, but the truth is, the author imagines humanity drove themselves to extinction long before our story begins. Their successors are mysterious, genetically modified superhumans known as the Doyum, who wish to give their Homo sapiens cousins a second chance. Traveling to the newly discovered Phtanum B, the powerful Doyum placed a reborn colony of humans on this habitable world, and watched their progress from afar. But what the last of humanity will find on this planet is an ecosystem much, much different from Earth's. Beginning with flora, plants, like everything on Phtanum B, reach gargantuan sizes. Here on the southern supercontinent, a lush world of red-tinted vegetation flourishes. The sheer amount of consumable biomass in this environment far exceeds that of any on Earth, allowing the organisms that feed on this flora to reach equally staggering sizes. One of the first of these animals that humans encounter are the giant Tyonocodite, relatively common herbivores with iridescent green skin due to algae that grows on their body, and symbiotically supplies them with extra energy. Giant Tyonocodite also gain energy by consuming plant matter in the surrounding environment, which they rip from the ground with their flexible, arm-like jaws. Strange as this might seem, Tyonocodite anatomy is a good average example of a body plan on Phtanum B. So let's take a closer look at the inner workings of these organisms. Beginning our dissection, the skeletal system of Tyonocodite and many other massive lifeforms we'll be exploring is made of pyrite, able to support far greater weight than the hydroxyapatite bones of earthly animals. Likewise, their muscle system is far more powerful than any Earth organism's, with core muscles made of more long-chained myosin fibers for basic movements, and a dedicated secondary system of muscles for more precise movement. Instead of a single brain, a decentralized neural system sends commands to these muscles, not unlike the neural systems of some types of starfish and coral. Finally, you'll notice that instead of eyes, most lifeforms on Phtanum B have ridges lined with infrared receptors on their heads. Most organisms also lack traditional mouths, instead having a mouth-like hole in between two tentacle-like arm jaws that bring food into the opening. But keep in mind, Tyonocodites are just a baseline, and life on Phtanum B gets even more interesting. A distant relative of the Tyonocodites are the plains-dwelling bronze cynalopes, lifeforms that use their strange, shuffle-like lower arm jaw to dig for food. These organisms move in great herds of up to 30 individuals, a survival strategy similar to the herding instincts of many animals here on Earth. At 10 feet, or 3.2 meters in length, bronze cynalopes could be considered megafauna on our own planet, but on Phtanum B, they're actually on the small side. This has led to some human explorers to attempt domesticating them, with mixed success. Along the volcanic shores of Phtanum B's coastal regions, a hunter is relentlessly pursuing its next meal. This is a black curvogalvid, a multi-limbed predator whose arm jaws have hardened into curved structures lined with pseudoteeth used to ensnare its prey. In this regard, the spiny jaws of the black curvogalvid are analogous to the mandibles of some Earth insects. These endurance hunters might be deadly to humans caught outside the walls of their colony, but they're actually just mid-sized predators on this world, which compared to Earth mid-sized predators puts into perspective how much bigger and scarier life can grow on Phtanum B. Less common are great frigatepedes, rarely encountered life forms that almost resemble extremely deadly living trains. Their multi-limbed body structure in some ways calls to mind the appearance of Earth insects like centipedes or caterpillars. Curiously, great frigatepedes hunt prey by ramming into them at high speeds, with their bony front body protrusion acting as a battering ram. After a successful use of this strange hunting technique, the creature's hooked jaw arms unfold from hidden pouches and tear apart the prey. And if that's not intimidating enough, great frigatepedes are true Goliaths, reaching almost 64 feet or 19.5 meters in length, although some of their distant relatives can grow even larger. Before we meet the relatives of the frigatepedes, there's another fascinating life form lurking in the snowy mountains. Here, far from the red plants of the lowlands, you can see the remains of its latest kill, meaning our culprit is close by. This is the bear trap hugger, a mountainous hunter that possesses a shaggy coat of silvery fibers to protect it from the cold, not unlike the fur of a polar bear on our own planet. Bear trap hugger ancestry isn't fully understood, but the bizarre biting apparatus at the front of its head is an effective knife-like tool when it comes to hunting prey. But far stranger hunters exist on Phtanum B. Returning to the lowlands, even the trees on Phtanum B can be deadly, although the Sathrical corpse tree isn't a tree in the traditional sense, but a xenocozoophyte, an organism that can gain sustenance from both the sun and other sources, which in the corpse tree's case includes living prey. Blending into the red vegetation, these odd predators strike down any animal that wanders too close with the large claw at the end of their arm. The speared prey is then inserted into a mouth-like hole near the base of the arm. Pretty terrifying. Another xenocozoophyte is the blitz spire, a lifeform so bizarre and unearthly it's hard to grasp at first. One of the single largest immobile organisms on Phtanum B, the blitz spire can reach a staggering 1,600 feet or 495 meters tall, and grows indefinitely throughout their life cycle until they literally collapse under their own weight and mass. The tip of the blitz spire has evolved, incredibly, to attract lightning strikes, the electrical currents of which can then be released to stun prey that gets too close to its underground feeding tendrils. These living skyscrapers are truly a life form unlike any other. The largest mobile predator in both modern and prehistoric times, however, is the giant lactismid, which has reached a scale most carnivores could only dream of. The larger relative of the frigatepedes, giant lactismids can reach 102 feet or 31.1 meters in length. The incredible bulk of this creature is supported by countless legs, including larger, weight-bearing outer limbs and pairs of thinner, hooked internal limbs that can aid in hunting prey. Giant lactismids also have alarmingly well-developed neural systems, which makes them aware enough to avoid most human settlements, although on rare occasions they've been known to hunt humans for sport. But even for a giant lactismid, not all life forms are easy to take down. Take the gargantuan castle walkers, a group that, as the name implies, are impenetrable living fortresses, and some of the heaviest terrestrial grazers on Phtanum B. Occupying a niche not entirely unlike an elephant on our planet, castle walkers vacuum up plant matter with a long jaw arm appendage covered in quills to scare off any predators. These creatures are also quite intelligent, able to communicate with other members of their species with Morse code-like ground vibrations that they can perceive through their feet. As you can see by this size comparison to other Phtanum B lifeforms, plus a T-Rex for good measure, castle walkers are true titans, reaching lengths of over 110 feet or 34 meters. But even castle walkers are small in comparison to the final lifeform we'll be visiting today. The immense red wind whales are among the most legendary and awe-inspiring lifeforms on Phtanum B. Gliding through the open skies, wind whales are mainly made up of air-filled cavities that allow them to stay aloft despite reaching lengths of over 425 feet or 130 meters, and possess wingspans nearly twice that length. Aided by the dense atmosphere, wind whales function like living paper planes, possessing retractable legs that work like grappling hooks to anchor them to the ground in turbulent weather. When these tethers fail, however, and a wind whale passes away, they create something called a whale fall, an event where organisms from all across Phtanum B come to feast on the fallen Titan. For the saga of Phtanum B is a story of life and death. And now, humans are a part of this story. At this point in the narrative's development, whether or not humans will be able to survive long-term in their new environment is unknown. Phtanum B is an ongoing project, so who knows what else might happen, and what else might be lurking on this alien world. Thanks for watching. Please consider supporting the author using the links below, and if you enjoyed this entry, please like, subscribe, and hit the notification icon to stay up to date on all things curious. See you in the next video.